Okay. In this video, we're going to look at a lot more volume stuff. And in many cases, we're going to set up the integral, but I would rely on the fact that you could actually integrate it, just in the interest of time. Okay. So this first one, the function f of x, 2x squared plus 1 on the interval from 1 to 3 is revolved around the x-axis. Find the volume of the solid. So we're looking at the shape, you know, from 1 to 3. So if we revolved it around, we'd get something that looked maybe like that. Okay. And as we revolve it, we have our cylinders that look kind of like that. Remember, we consider the width to be dx, and we get the radius by evaluating the function. So the radius is equal to 2x squared plus 1. So remember, what we're essentially doing here is we're finding the volume of the cylinder, which is pi r squared multiplied by the height. And then we integrate that, in our case, from 1 to 3. Now, if you wanted to actually go ahead and integrate this, you'd pull the pi out. I would write this out twice like this, 2x squared plus 1 multiplied by 2x squared plus 1. And then, you know, you'd actually multiply everything out. So you'd have 4x to the 4th plus 4x squared plus 1. And then you would integrate that. You'd have 4 fifths x to the 5th plus 4 thirds x cubed plus x. Evaluate at 3 and 1, and you'd multiply your answer by pi. In the interest of time, I'm going to rely on the fact that you could do that. What I really wanted to just focus on here was, if you looked at this thing head on, you know, you looked at this shape from the front, you could see it three-dimensionally, what you'd be looking at is a circle, right? And it has a radius that's given by our function. Okay, and that's a key to this, so I want you to keep in mind. As you look at it, that's what you would be seeing head-on. You'd just be seeing circles. Okay? Now, real quick, before we get to finding some different volumes, I just want to make sure we realize that this statement, x squared minus y squared equals x minus y squared, is most definitely false. There are lots of ways to look at it. Of course, you could expand this out and see they're not the same. But if you just want to check with a number, you know, 5 squared minus 4 squared is 16. 25 minus 16 is 9. That's definitely not the same as 5 minus 4 squared.
Okay, that statement is false. That is not something algebraically we can reduce. And that's a key to what we're about to do.
So, a cup is made by rotating the area between 2x squared and x plus 1 around the x-axis. Okay, find the volume of the material needed. So you can see the original function, you can see its rotation. What's different is now, as you look at this, you know, you can see that the cylinder, of course, dx is still the height, but you can see that it looks kind of head-on. Instead of like a circle, it looks like a donut or a washer. So I want you to think about this. We've got this circle with another circle inside it. Okay? And the big circle, let's say, has a radius of big R, and the little circle has a radius of little r. Okay? If I wanted to find the area,
kind of shade it in there, looks like a sprinkled donut or something,
I would do the area of the big circle minus the area of the little circle. I could maybe pull a pi out and have r squared minus r squared,
but that's it. That is how I would find the area of that circle. Well, remember that our width is dx, so our volume
would be the area multiplied by the height, which is just dx. So we're going to integrate. In our case, from 0 to 1, notice that those are the bounds. It starts at 0 and goes to 1. You know I like to pull the pi up front. Well, now we need to figure out what the big radius is. Well, the big radius is the bigger function. So it's x plus 1. Okay. I'm going to put a little capital R above it just so you see. It's the big radius. Okay. The little radius is the smaller of the two functions on this interval. So that's 2x squared. Again, I'm going to put a little r above it. So you see that it's the smaller radius. And this is it. If you wanted to do it by hand, you would expand this out. X squared plus 2x plus 1 minus 4x to the fourth. Otherwise, you could use your calculator. But this is how you would find the volume. So again, it's the area of the big circle minus the area of the little circle. Remember, dx is the height of our cylinders. I factored a pi out. Another thing you could have done is we actually could have integrated right here. We could have integrated each radius squared separately and said, you know, what's the total volume of the bigger shape minus the total volume of this little kind of white cone-like shape. And that would have given us the same answer. That's just a property of integrals that we can do that. But this formula right here is really key. Sometimes it's called the washer method, because if you know what a washer looks like, it looks exactly like that. It's a little thickness and a big circle with a little circle cut out. Let's do another. This one is a little bit different in that this time I want to rotate around. You see it says f of x is x squared, g of x is x. Rotate this area around the line y equals negative 1. Okay, so now instead of rotating around the axis, I'm rotating around y equals negative 1. This is called the axis of rotation. Well, originally, you know, if I was rotating around the axis, let me just draw what that would look like here if I was, well, that was not a great drawing, but you get it. If I was rotating around, then it would look something like this, the little thickness like that. It would look something like that. And the top radius would be x and the bottom radius, or the bigger radius would be x and the smaller radius would be x squared. So what you need to do here is you need to say, well, the bigger radius here around the axis was just x. Well, this is x right here. So what have I done to the radius? Well, I've made it one unit bigger. So if you think about this kind of general form of pi r squared minus pi r squared, the bigger radius is now x plus 1. Because if I was just going around the axis, it would have just been x. But I'm not. I'm going around a line that's one unit below the axis, and that made the radius one unit larger. Well, the inner radius or smaller radius would have been x squared. And what happened to that? Well, I also made that one unit bigger. Okay? So this is your big R, and this is your little r. Now, sometimes people will make the mistake of leaving that plus 1 out and just squaring the x and the x squared. Remember, that's part of your radius. You've made the radius one unit bigger, so you need to reflect that. So we would now integrate. The bounds here are 0 and 1. We would have the big radius squared minus the little radius squared dx. And again, you could do that by hand. You could use fn int. In the interest of time, I'm going to just move on to another example. What if I took the same shape, and instead of rotating it around the line y equals negative 1, let's say I rotate around the line y equals 2. Okay, so now I would have something up here. It looks like that. Okay, so now that gets a little confusing here. All right. I don't know that that picture helped or that that helped. So remember, this right here is x squared. And you'll notice that now is our larger circle. Okay. Well, if you're thinking about going up to 2, the difference between 2 and the axis is 2 units. But I don't want to go all the way to 2. I don't want to go all the way down to the axis. I want to only go from here. The radius is 2 down to the axis less x squared. So now, if you think about, you know, pi r squared minus pi r squared, the large radius is 2 minus x squared. Okay? Make sure you see that, that we start here. This is our axis of rotation. It's 2 units all the way down. We don't want to go all the way down. We want to come back x squared units. So the radius is x squared units less than 2. So that little radius would be 2 minus x squared. So now we would integrate from 0 to 1. 2 minus x squared squared minus 2 minus x squared. And dx again represents the width. So these ones always are a little bit tricky in that, you know, you need to recognize the fact that it's rotating up. So number one, what was the lower function now sets the bigger circle. It's, you know, it's the radius of the larger circle because it's kind of your outer shell of your shape. But then you also need to recognize that, you know, instead of making the, like when we rotate around negative 1, we made the radius bigger. Well, we didn't necessarily make the radius smaller, but it's not anymore in relation to the axis. It's in relation to 2. So we need to say, well, it's x squared, or in the second radius, x units less than 2. And we need to then reflect that in our radius, 2 minus x squared, 2 minus x. Now, you know, if you were rotating around the line y equals 7, then it would be 7 minus x squared, 7 minus x. Just like in the previous example, if instead of rotating around negative 1, we were rotating around negative 5, we made the radius 5 units bigger. So it would be x plus 5 and x squared plus 5. So you kind of need to play with these, maybe draw a picture as you go. Last one. Find the volume of the solid of revolution generated by rotating the curve y equals x cubed between y equals 0 and y equals 4 about the y-axis. So this one's a little bit different, but I drew in the cylinder. I wanted you to see that where the thickness before had always been in relation to x, this thickness is actually in relation to y. So we're going to be doing dy now. So the area of our, or the volume, well, we need the radius, but now we need it to be in terms of y. So we've got to take our equation, y equals x cubed, and rewrite it as an x equals, of course it would be the cube root of y. So our volume would be pi r squared multiplied by the height. So we'd integrate that. I like to pull that pi up front. And the bounds, well, it's in terms of y, so we start at 0, and we ended at 4. So those are our bounds. Again, I'm going to leave that to you. You know, you could certainly rewrite this as, like, y to the 2/3 power. That's a nice, easy integral, then raise the power to to 5/3 divide, you know, 3/5 wide of the 5/3, put in 4, plug in 0. But I'll leave that to you to do.